Thank you. As the sun sets on our time here at Punahou, the moment is heartbreaking, yet inspiring.
We are surrounded by an array of colors, a diverse group of personalities, each day immersing ourselves in these experiences and emotions that take our breath away.
Once the sun sets, life may prove to be challenging, dark, and uncertain. During these times of darkness, we must reflect upon our lessons learned here.
From our past experiences, we will gather the strength needed to overcome the dark times. And from that, we know the sun will rise again, bringing hope and good times ahead. Now let us all please join together and sing on Eagle's Wings.
Have come to this Baccalaureate service for the Punahou School Class of 2006. On behalf of Central Union Church, I welcome all of you, the staff, the faculty, and especially you. As I look upon you, I understand that you are the future. It is exciting to look upon the future. I wish you all well, and to have a future that will be filled with opportunities that will be met. Will you join with me now for our invocation? O Christ, to invite you into presence is dangerous. When we invite you in, then nothing is safe from your touch. Nothing can remain the same. We become what you would have us be instead of what we would make ourselves. We become the servants of the world instead of the possessors of it. We become the followers rather than the leaders. When we invite you to join in, then nothing can stay the same, and that makes you dangerous to all those that would have the world the way it is. O Christ, join our lives tonight and tomorrow and every day, and let us become what you would have us be. Help us to not be afraid of what you can do and where you can lead, for we trust your presence and we trust your leading. O Christ, come to us. and make us yours. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
The class is chosen for the Old Testament reading, Psalm 139. O Lord, you examine me and you know me. You know if I am standing or sitting. You read my thoughts from afar. Whether I walk or lie down, you are watching. You are familiar with all my ways. The word is not even on my tongue before you know it completely, O Lord. Close behind and close in front, you fence me in around, shielding me with your hand. Such knowledge is beyond my understanding, a height to which my mind cannot attain. Where could I go to escape your spirit? Where could I flee from your presence? If I climb to the heavens, you are there. There too, if I lie in the depths. If I rise on the wings of the dawn, if I settle on the far side of the sea, your hand would still be guiding me, your right hand holding me. If I ask darkness to cover me and light to become night around me, the darkness would not be dark to you. Night would be as light as day. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Probe me and know my thoughts. Make sure I do not follow evil ways, and guide me in the way everlasting.
A reading from the New Testament selected by the class of 2006. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, and I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them, and he will be his people, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more, mourning and crying and pain will be no more." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." And he also said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true. It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life. Those who conquer will inherit these things, and I will be their God, and they will be my children."
In the past 20 years, my parents have loyally attended over 25 Punahou Academy open houses, 7 college meetings, 7 variety shows, and the list goes on. No wonder my parents often displayed the been there, done that attitude. Even my siblings say, some things never change. I argue, no other class has a student who bakes batches of cookies every other Friday, or another student who overtly discusses politics in every class, even math. Our class is different in that we have drive like no other and that we will conquer the world. But my sisters and brothers argue that they too felt these ambitions. Understanding this, I have come to realize that perhaps my siblings and I are both correct. In the old days, the rad shows were Melrose Place and Beverly Hills 90210. Now, the hot series are the OC and Laguna Beach. Then, students pass notes in assemblies. Now, kids discreetly text message. Then, everyone wanted a Walkman. Now, iPods of all sorts. Then, SAT scores of 1600. Now, unfortunately, SAT scores of 2400. Then, tuition of $7,000. Now, again, unfortunately, tuition of $14,000. But don't be discouraged. Some changes were for the better. Instead of typewriters, we use computers with printers. Instead of actually going to the library to do research, we Google it, although it takes longer, thanks to IM. You get the point. A lot changed. But a lot remained the same. Senior prom, skip day, variety show. But most importantly, the graduating classes are all similar in that we take with us friendship and optimism. My siblings were optimistic because Punahou prepared them well. We are optimistic because Punahou prepared us well. My siblings still have a handful of their high school friends, and hopefully we will stay close friends too. But our class is different. We make this Punahou class of 2006 unique. My parents may have done this baccalaureate scene in the past, but not with us, here. Out of thousands of graduating classes, our experiences are different, because no one else is graduating this year with these young men and women from Punahou School. So, yes, traditions may never change, but graduating classes change. The explanation is quite simple. It's the time, the place, and the people. Of course, our parents and the entire Punahou community greatly influenced us and even shaped us into the Punahou class of 2006. But essentially, it was us. We chose to study, or not to. We chose to practice, volunteer, participate, rehearse, contribute. Us. We are here today because of our hard work and decisions along the way. So, class of 2006, be proud of yourselves, and congratulations.
Thank you. Lao Tzu said, a journey of 1,000 miles begins with one step. 4 years ago, we took our first step in the academy. In less than a week, we will complete our journey. Our class has been described as exceptionally bright, multifaceted, and multi-talented. We are a class of individuals with a wide range of interests and goals. Thus, one might think that we cannot come together as a class, but in fact, our differences complement each other, and we've all made our own contributions to the class of 2006. As members, we share its triumphs, victories, and milestones. The first ILH championship in 28 years in football, defeating St. Louis not once, not twice, but 3 times. The Symphony Orchestra selected to play on national public radio. The chorale invited to sing at High Mass at the Vatican. The variety show deemed as one of the best in recent Punahou history. And as of last week, the class of 2006 now holds our school record for the most athletic state championships won. Wow. We have done much to be proud of and are finally reaching the destination we set out for 4 years ago. We are nearing the end of our journey. Though most of us have taken our own unique paths on our academic odyssey, our paths have begun to converge, leading us on the road toward graduation. The sundial in the middle of our academy quad illuminates this convergence metaphorically. It marks the center where our paths come together for one brief moment before once again diverging. 6 days from now, we will come together one last time as the Punahou class of 2006 to celebrate who we are and what we share in common. Friends, make the most of these last few days. This is a time to reconnect with old acquaintances, a time to bury old hatchets, a time to finally say hello to that special someone you've been meaning to talk to all year. A week from tonight marks the beginning of a new journey. Again, we will be setting off on our own separate paths. Some of us will take the well-trodden path. Others will choose the path less taken. But all of us will take the lessons we have learned at Punahou, the importance of hard work, perseverance, and integrity. We will take lessons that we have learned from each other, the value of friendship, teamwork, and patience. It is inevitable that we will all face difficulty, hardships, and disappointments along the way. But with what we have gained at Punahou, no matter what we encounter or how long the journey, we, the class of 2006, will endure. We will leave our mark on the world as we have left our mark on Punahou. Class of 2006, as we end this last week together and we begin our own separate journeys, I'd like to leave you with the Irish blessing. May the road rise to meet you. May the wind blow at your back. May the sun shine warmly on your face. May the rains fall softly on your field. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand.
wake up. It's time for baccalaureate. But I didn't want to wake up because I was having these amazing dreams about the seniors. Were you dreaming too?
Yeah, me too, now that you mention it. I've been dreaming a lot about the end of our time with the class of 2006. What were you dreaming about?
Oh, I dreamed that I was a little girl in junior school, and some adult asked me what I wanted to be when I grew up. I wanted to be a United Airlines sales representative who made the reservations for people wanting to travel to exotic places like San Francisco and Disneyland.
I wanted to be a baseball player. I would have played for anybody.
That's cool, Scott. And I also dreamed about being in the fifth grade at Punahou and having so many different activities to participate in, I just couldn't choose. There was art and choir, lunchtime basketball, and the newspaper. What did you do, Scott?
I was the projector monitor. And one time when I was rewinding the film while everyone else was out at recess, I had to go to the bathroom and I left the projector running.
That's cool, Scott. And my next dream was strangely about the seventh and eighth grade canteens at Punahou and waiting for this really cute guy to walk across the dance floor to ask me to dance.
That's cool, Lynn, but we don't have that much time. I still wanted to play. I still wanted to play baseball.
Well, everyone has to have a dream. Oh, wait. This isn't about our dreams.
This is about your dreams. You have had an amazing 4 years, full of scholarly, athletic, and artistic successes. Just think about all that you've accomplished already.
Scott, do you think that maybe we, the deans, had anything to do with the class's tremendous achievements?
Nah.
However, your ability to dream in the present has had a lot to do with your class's successes.
When you were in elementary school, you were dreamers of dreams, and your teachers and parents supported you and helped you cultivate your ideas. And as you grew older, your ideas came into sharper focus and transcended, becoming visions. Not only visions of high school life, but life beyond Punahou.
Some people believe that dreams and visions are ways that God calls, challenges, and graces us to think about our futures. Dreams and visions offer us revelations and sources of hope for the future. Long ago, according to the legend you all know, an aged Hawaiian couple lived on the slope of Rocky Hill and had to travel for water. They prayed for a spring. And in a dream answering their prayers, they were told to uproot the stump of an old hala tree, which they did, and found a spring of clear, sweet water, which they named Ka Punahou.
This dream changed their futures, and your dreams will ultimately shape your futures as well. The dreams and expectations you had in the junior school about life in the academy are now your fond memories. And the dreams and opportunities you have about colleges will also lead to new memories. And next year, wherever you may find yourselves, perhaps trying to ward off a little homesickness, remember that you can always look to the heavens and recall the words of the song your classmates sang in senior chapel from Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
Somewhere over the rainbow, skies are blue, and the dreams that you dare to dream really do come true. So as you face your future, remember to be dreamers of dreams, and you will continue to see visions.
But beyond these dreams and visions, know this. Know what your parents already know.
And know...
Know what your grandparents already know.
Know what your aunties and uncles know. Know what your teachers already know. And know what your classmates already know.
And know what we know. You are more than dreamers and visionaries. You are more than vessels of memories. To paraphrase Shakespeare, you are yourselves, already the stuff of dreams. You are already dreams come true for all who love you and cherish you.
Live believing dreams are for weaving, wonders are waiting to start. Live your story, faith, hope, and glory. Hold to the truth in your heart. We wish for you to keep dreaming, lead wonderful, interesting, and blessed lives. May you all have wonderful dreams to carry you into the future. Godspeed.
Thank you. Dr. Scott, Dr. Conway, deans, and parents and guests, and especially you, the graduating class of 2006. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Creator, Redeemer, and Counselor. Like every baccalaureate speaker, I have to begin by thanking you seniors for honoring me to speak to you on this special occasion. After hearing all the teachers who spoke to you in our Journey Chapels this year, I'm humbled to be singled out when there are so many wise and knowledgeable teachers who make up the faculty at Punahou. I have to confess that as I sat down to compose the speech, I was cursing you and wondering what madness possessed me to accept this responsibility. And as I stomped around the room trying to figure out where to start, I have to admit that I allowed myself to be sidetracked by almost anything. Some stupid TV ad, a newspaper headline, and to show you how frustrated I was, I even folded laundry. You know the feeling. It's like trying to get started on that term paper on which your whole life depends. I didn't even know what baccalaureate meant. I mean, I remember it was on my college diploma, Artis Baccalaureans, and according to Wikipedia, another definition is a farewell speech to a graduating class, usually at commencement. So at Punahou, this service is a time for your teachers and or coaches or mentors to say farewell. And I thank you for allowing me to represent them. I know that in the broad scope of things at graduation, baccalaureate is going to be overshadowed by June 3rd, 2006. Today is just a prelude of what's going to happen in Blaisdell Arena next Saturday night. So if it isn't that important, why am I so stressed and anxious? I'm anxious because I want to say something that's useful to you as you begin your next phase in your journey. Like your teachers and deans and others at our school, I love you, seniors. I've sort of grown up with you. I remember you as freshmen, and I remember your freshman dance and in Dole Hall cafeteria, and how you tried to look so grown up and like real high school kids, whatever that meant. But I've watched you as you proceeded through the academy and became high school students. Even more, you became Punahou seniors and all that that means and represents. When you were seventh graders, Chaplain Turner began the school year by talking about how the sun shed its light over the Punahou campus. And he told you that the sun shines first on Wilcox Hall, just as a student's journey began in kindergarten. Then the sun shines on Winnie and Castle and Bishop and finally to the academy. In the same way that the light of learning spreads from Wilcox of a child in kindergarten then on to high school. But he was wrong. The sunlight doesn't hit the campus in that order. At this time of year, the sun comes up over Rocky Hill, and the first light hits the academy, and then Case Middle School and Castle and so on. But as I researched Chaplain Turner's error and traced the shadow cast by the sun in the morning, I realized that this is sort of what you folks are doing right now as you end your careers at Punahou. Your thoughts are on graduation, and you think back maybe to the prom and the variety show. And as you reminisce with your friends, you think backwards in time. The carnival, the sophomore luau, the shock and awe of coming into the academy as freshmen. The athletic events and the concerts and the activities that enriched your lives as well as ours. And some of you even remember those chapel extravaganzas with Mrs. Lowry. And while you were in junior school, some of you went to camps at Mokulele'a and Timberline. And of course, there was the Big Island trip. But many of you didn't come to Punahou in kindergarten. So your memories won't include all of those places or things. But each of you has your own special memories from your own middle school and elementary school. And as each of you traces the shadow of your personal experience, you realize that your high school experience is not an isolated period in education. What and how you learned in the middle school affected you in the academy. And in the same way, your elementary school experiences impacted your middle school achievements. So now as you leave Punahou, you're very aware that what has happened for you and to you in these last 4 years is going to cast a shadow of influence in your lives in college and in your careers. Because all of you did not start at Punahou in Wilcox Hall, your educational memories may be a little bit different than those in the 13 plus or 13 year club. But because each of you has influenced and been influenced by your classmates, you seniors are a product not only of Punahou, but other private and public schools. A Punahou education really is a melting pot of many schools and many learning opportunities. I think Dr. Scott and the trustees have recognized that when they have set forth a vision for us to be a private school with a public purpose. As a graduate of this school, I hope you keep this in mind. You are not merely a son or daughter of Punahou. You are truly sons and daughters of Oahu, Hawaii, and the wider world. And we as parents and teachers and friends dream of when you will return to build a stronger, healthier Hawaii. The writer of Ecclesiastes in the Bible tells us, "For if a man lives many years, let him rejoice in them all. But let him remember that the days of darkness will be many." You're at one of these times of rejoicing. But I know that some of you have had some days of darkness along the way. And Scripture encourages us not to deny or forget those hard times. As many of our chapel speakers have shared their own journeys in this past year, you learned how they grew and were strengthened by these difficulties. And in the assembly on Thursday, I think it was Dr. Conway who noted that our hard times often help to give our good times depth and meaning. And in chapels and in classes, you've learned that your teachers' lives were enriched and broadened when they discovered that by serving others, they found meaning in their lives. That's why in teaching you seniors, we teachers have learned. You and every student that we've taught have been our teachers, and for that we thank you. Now, as we've retraced the shadows of your Punahou experience from Cook Hall back to Wilcox, I don't want you to think that I'm dissing Chaplain Turner because of his gross error. I realize, like so many other Punahou teachers, he was using metaphor to paint a word picture for us. But for an anal ex-math teacher, that's hard for me to do. But as I think about your graduation and your transition to college and career, his metaphor seems to be a good way to describe what is happening and what will happen. The sunshine of learning and experience that began in kindergarten casts its light on your education in elementary school and grew in brightness through the academy. And now the light spreads further and wider as you move to colleges far and near. At this point in my speech preparation, I pulled out my book of quotations with hopes of appearing scholarly. But many of you had me in class, and you know that I'm anything but a scholar. So rather than some quotes from some famous people, I decided to tell you a story instead. If you've gone to church, maybe you've heard this one. The minister called all the children to the front of the church to tell a children's sermon. And he began by saying, "I'm thinking about something that's furry and has a long bushy tail, climbs in trees, and loves nuts. Can you guess what I'm thinking about?" And the children were very quiet as they thought and thought. And finally, one little girl raised her hand and said, "Pastor, it really sounds like a squirrel, but I know you want us to say God." That's one kind of learning. Students spouting out answers, regurgitating responses that they know that the teacher wants to hear. Rote learning and robotic behavior. And that's an educational system that worked for decades. Probably your parents and your teachers learned that way. I know I did. And when I went to South Africa with Teachers Without Borders, that was how the South African children learned. But they had to take an exam in order to get into college. But the South African educators decided that that was not the best way, that they needed to teach their students to become problem solvers. As Rebecca pointed out in her speech earlier this evening, this is a rapidly changing world. Rote learning and memorization, which once served us in the 20th century, can't meet the challenges of the new technologies and globalization. We're finding old ways of handling problems are not sufficient to meet the current challenges and problems that confront us. At Punahou, you've learned that there isn't just one way to solve a problem. I know that Punahou students have learned that there may be many possibilities to attain a desired outcome. You folks remind me of that little girl who went to her pediatrician for a regular checkup. And when the doctor put the stethoscope to her chest, he asked her, "I wonder who I'm going to hear in your heart, Big Bird?" And she quickly replied, "No, Big Bird's on my panties. God is in my heart. You seniors are like that. You have learned not to give us canned answers. You've begun to look at other possibilities. There isn't always just one answer to a problem. In math, you learn that there may be one answer, but often there are many possible ways to get to that solution. In your history and English courses, you've learned to look at several perspectives to a particular situation. When Mr. Cheever spoke to you in the Senate chapel a couple of weeks ago, he said what many of us teachers feel, that you've been equipped to respond to the problems and issues that will face this world in the next several years. Punahou has equipped you to be problem solvers. Nicole said that same thing in your senior chapel. In other words, you've learned to use rote methods when they've been appropriate. But more than that, you've learned how to use that information to apply and expand that knowledge to new and different situations. Mr. Cheever said he sees the world, or your future, or the future of the world, optimistically. He sees the glass half full because he knows that Punahou has given you the tools to build the structures for the 21st century. My generation is discovering that what worked in the 19th and 20th centuries aren't always that effective any longer. We're learning that governments themselves are conflicted over how to make things work. And it seems that the religious worldviews are more visibly divergent and divisive than ever. And what are we going to do about poverty and hunger and global warming and the energy situation? And you know that your baby boomer teachers are getting grayer and grayer. That also means that our government and business leaders are aging. They've influenced our world for the last 40 years. what's going to happen as they age. How can Mr. Cheever be so optimistic? Well, he made it very clear that he wasn't optimistic because he thought that that was what you wanted to hear. He wasn't like those false prophets of Israel who kept saying to the people, peace, peace, when there was no peace. He basically said, there is hope. If you and all the people of your generation look at the problems and the challenges of our world with new lenses, my lens can't even see what new jobs, what new technologies, what different dynamics are going to shape the 21st century. If we taught you that those old structures and institutions are the ones that will meet the problems and challenges of the future, we would have done you a great disservice. Your teachers are optimistic because we believe that you have learned to analyze problems, to apply previously learned information, and to synthesize that knowledge to meet new challenges. But more than that, Punahou has taught you not only to be informed, but to be compassionate and committed to justice. Punahou and today's technologies have made so much knowledge available to you. In fact, we can predict that newer technologies will multiply that knowledge even more. But you have learned here that we need more than knowledge and information. The Bible tells us that the beginning of wisdom is the respect and fear of God. Although Punahou has not pushed a particular religious agenda on you, we have urged you to explore a spiritual dimension of life. We want you to ask those religious questions. Who are you? Who or what is God? What is truth? What is justice? What is your purpose in life? And that's another reason that we're so optimistic about you. You are equipped to confront the future, not merely with sterile organizations and structures, but you will color them with human and humane values, compassion, love, respect, courage, and freedom. You have learned that you are your brother's keeper. And when you help your brother, you find meaning. You have learned that Hawaii is no longer an isolated island in the Pacific. Hawaii is a part of a larger global community. But why am I so serious? You're only 18 years old. You have movies to see, and beaches to go to, and parties to attend. Well, if that's all people see, it's no wonder they predict gloom and doom. But that's not what your teachers see. We see much more. We see you ready to go off to college, to expand your learning and experiences, and to grow in wisdom. The writer of Ecclesiastes says, "Rejoice, O young one, in your youth. And let your heart cheer you in the days of your youth. Walk in the ways of your heart and the sight of your eyes." We teachers see the ways of your heart in your concern for others and each other, for our environment. And as you've responded in your involvement in many areas of service, we have seen what your heart desires. We see in your eyes dreams and hope and optimism. That's why we want you to go ahead and have your fun. Enjoy your youth, because it will not be long when you'll be asked to step forward and to lead. You will be challenged to care for your brother and our world, to do justice, to love kindness, and to walk humbly with your God. And most of all, please know and remember that your teachers believe that the glass is not half empty, it is half full. You know that Punahou is not the end. So continue to fill that glass. There is so much more for you. And we trust that the shadow you will cast will extend far beyond Wilcox and Cook Hall. God bless you, and aloha.
Loving God, we have gathered at the sunset of one life experience to look back, to remember, and to acknowledge your guidance and presence as constants in the midst of all of the changes of life. We thank you for what we've shared this evening, the words and songs, the laughter and tears, the wisdom articulated, and those thoughts too deep for mere words. Our hearts swell with pride to see these young men and women of our class of 2006, and we look forward with great joy to the future dawning bright with promise before them. As they step into this new sunrise, may the grace and mystery of the night blooming Sirius go with them. May the joy of catching tadpoles in the lily pond go with them. May the peace of a manoa rainbow go with them. May the beauty of a slack key melody go with them. May the fragrance of pikake and maile go with them, a makapu'u sunrise and a diamond head sunset. May the pride and joy sparkling in the eyes of their parents and teachers and friends go with them. And may your love, O God, surround them and bless them as you hold them in the palm of your almighty hand. Amen. Please remain standing as the senior class sings the Queen's Prayer, and then the congregation may be seated as our graduates recess. How we thank you for honoring them with your presence this evening.